Hey guys, welcome to today's tutorial, and I'll be doing a tutorial on detailed map making in QGIS. And in this I'll cover a number of issues, and first one will be like introduction to the map composer itself. Then I'll do we explore the different composer tools that exist. Then we check on the different map elements that maybe every map should contain. And then we'll export the maps that we've made in different formats. So right away, I'll go to my QGIS project. So here it is. One, I want to make a map that will be having two layers. It will have roads and administration boundaries. So I'll be showing how to make a map until maybe someone prints it out, like the end product. So I begin by loading the shapefile that we'll be using. So for this one, maybe I'll do, let me go to one, then that one, then maybe I can locate roads. This one, I load this one. Yeah, that it is. So I'll change the symbology here. Let me, for example, come and I can choose how maybe do this. Then symbol levels, enable symbol levels. There you are. Yeah, so at least maybe we can change the white part to be somehow. Let me, maybe we can have brown, maybe something like that. Yeah, so we'll be doing a map for this, but for one, I want to maybe export the roads data, so that at least I want to classify my data, the roads data, in different categories. And I'll be doing using the description here. So secondary, we have different aspects, so we can classify these, and we come to categorize. Then I use the second, which is the route description. Then I classify. There, apply. Oh, let me enable the symbol levels. At least I can change for this. Maybe give it another color. Can check that, for example. Oh, that's too dark, but okay, let me change this. We might maybe can add the transparency, but let me see. There you are. But at least to make some sense, we have three classes of the categorization of the different roads that we have. The data itself is somehow clumsy, so don't worry. But what I want to show is at least if we classify the layer, the root data, we have the different types: primary root, secondary root, and the unknown. As you can see, most of them are found in the unknown. So so we'll be making a map for this that maybe shows the different categories of or the different types of roads that exist. And this one will be guided upon by some of the issues, like if we want, for example, we want to show the different categories of the roads, the three types, and then we show that these data or these roads exist in a certain geographical area, which now in this scenario it's the country. So what we'll be doing is we're going to map making, and then we have the two layers. So in QGIS, if you want to make a map, you come to the project here. Then there's an option of there's a print composer. So if you click on this, it'll ask you to save a number of the name of the composer that you want, or the title. And maybe this one you can call it tutorial. and then click OK. So it opens this window, which is like another application inside QGIS. And by the look of it, you can see that there are so many tools or buttons that all achieve a certain task. So this is what we'll be using, and maybe this one we can. So I'll start by the basics. So one, we'll set the environment where we'll be working. Then secondly, we load our layers here, then we continue. So you can set the page size to begin with. So I want, for example, A3, that size, so that's bigger a little bit. Yeah, that's better. So 297 by 420. Yeah, that's better. So as you can see, now it's like a new application. So there are a lot of functionality that exist. We have all this functionality here. You can start a new one. You can maybe export, or maybe check all the composers that you have. You can export your data, save to different templates. We also have the editing, just like the one in QGIS. And then we have the view, the same one. Like, we have the layout. These ones are options for this, yeah, the ones that exist in this toolbar. And then we have the atlas, where you can develop atlas from your maps. And then the settings, of course. On this side, we have three tabs. We have the composition, which gives the quick properties for this environment that we're working on. And then you have the item properties. So item properties, on us, it's specific to a certain item. If you had a legend, its properties are shown here. And then we have atlas generation, whereby you can generate your atlases from the maps that you make. So to begin with, we have data here in our QGIS project. So we need to get this data into our print composer here. So there are tools here on this side. So for example, we can this is span. We have select, we have even move items, we have add a new map, we have legend, we have a scale bar, we have attribute table. So all these are tools or items that you can add into your map. So I'll begin by adding the map, for example. And I want to do this by first of all adding the, so I remove the Kenya or the boundaries, then I remain with the roads. If I come here, so I take this one, which is add new map, and then you click and drag. Then, now the roads data is brought into our composer. And to move this, for example, you can just use this one. So you click on it and you can move the data or the layer to where you want it to be. And then one good thing is once now this is here, if you check on the item properties, now the properties are populated. And this one, you can add different aspects, like maybe the frame. Yeah, you can choose the type of frame that you want. You can also do like if you want the grids, for example, you can add maybe the position size. You do custom that maybe of the specifications depending on what you are doing, and all these options that you can have. So once that's done, now we can maybe you can resize this one a little bit to that. Yeah, to that. Then maybe you can push it downward a little bit. Yeah, there. Then you come to when I want. What I want is I want a map that showing roads data on this side, and then maybe can have the boundaries on this other part. Now in this scenario, we'll be having two maps. So how do you add two maps in such a composer? You just use the same tool, but sometimes you find that when you add two maps, they kind of like they override each other. So if I come to my QGIS here and maybe activate that, and then I go back to this and I try to draw a new map, for example, like this. So this one will come with the Kenya and the roads. So it's different from this one. But now, after some time, if, for example, I come to this and I click, for example, on this, like there's some functionality that when we conduct, or maybe when you go to some other items, for example, when adding legends and all that, at times you find that this, your map one might override, might be overridden by, overwritten by the second map. So to avoid this, sometimes there are options that exist that you can use. So for example, you can lock layers to map items, this one, and then you can also lock the style. So even if I delete this and I come back to QGIS here and change, for example, one of these, or maybe like now for the Kenya, I come and maybe change to something like that. So if I change and check this, okay, this is somehow done. Let me add a good color. Yeah, there you go. So if I add this one now and I come to this and add a new map, so at least yeah. So I have Kenya only, and I can still lock this to layers and the layer styles. So whichever operation I do in my in such a project, this won't change because I've already locked these items. Yeah, so that's one type of maybe a way that you can prevent such issues when you're working with maybe huge data or many layers in such a project. So now we have two maps. We have roads and we have the Kenya map here. So this is when you click on this, when you click on this, now at least it gives you hints. So I've done something that's not supposed to be done. Yeah. So if you have this one, we can add a frame for this. And if you check this one now, at least you can update preview. So if I hadn't locked this one, for example, and then I come and update preview. So you see, so this is the issue I'm saying. So at least on map zero, if I hadn't locked that, so at least you find that when you preview, or maybe it's the layer is updated, it alters the first map. So we'll be forced to go back and I go back to this, my styles here, and then check this, come here, draw our roads again. So there you are, and push them a little bit, then I come just here. There you are. Okay, then we come add frame. Yeah. So at least now we have maps, two maps in our composer that at least represent what we're working in our QGIS project. And now we can continue adding the other elements in into the map. So the basic element that must be contained in a map, for example, we must have maybe something like legend, scale, maybe the title of that map, the author, the coordinate reference system, and all those, the node arrow. So you must include them. Where you include them, for example, the location or maybe the size, that all depends now on your need. There's no specific like approach that you can tell someone, maybe you need to stick to this. That depends on them. They're all found here. So if, for example, it's a title, we'll add a text, a label here, which is text. So just add this, maybe a tag there, then it appears here. So I can always change the font here because this is too small. So they can put 28 or maybe 26 is so big. So around 22 there. Yeah, then I make maybe say a map of roads in Kenya. Yeah, so something like that. So it's automatically updated here, and we can resize these, and yeah, something like that. So we can add maybe to the font, maybe somehow smaller. Yeah, can make it bigger a little bit. Then yeah, something like that. And then we can also change some of the like You can do the underlining or striking out, but you cannot strike out the title. So yeah, you underline that way. Then we add the legend. So here's the legend. So we can draw it here. So the legend, depending on the number of layers that you have, sometimes the legend spans out to be so big. For example, when working on a project that has about 20 layers, so you find they fitting on one column might be an issue. So to tackle these, you just come to the item properties once it's highlighted, and then you might come and do some editing depending on how you want it to appear. So if it's, for example, there are 20 layers, so you just come to columns and then maybe change to about 2, yeah, or 3, yeah, and then they appear as a, they will appear in a very good, yeah, in a very good way. But my mind is just too little, so I just do one column. You can also change the symbol width that you want. Maybe this element where there's a symbol here, maybe you might want to change how it appears. So that's for the legend. And actually, if you want also to like for how you want it to blend with the map, you can always edit the values here. So so that's one way of doing it. Then you have this part, which is for the items. You can always, once you update your maps here, you can always update, for example, or maybe put it out to update to change the legend items automatically. Okay, so that's for the legend. So we can come and add maybe for the basket, the scale bar, so you just put it somewhere in a nice place, yeah, something like that. Then you might add, for example, the coordinate reference system. So you just, the same to title, you use the label feature here. So might come, it says here is, it's maybe, WGS 84. So something like that. So you come to font again. So yeah, you change to 28. Yeah, something like that. Then we have the north arrow. In QGIS, when you're doing the north the arrow, so there's one thing that you need to know, that the arrow head, the head points where you finish drawing your arrow to. So so if you need to point north, so which means it's upwards, so you'll have to draw from below and then upwards. So make it straight there, just like that. So maybe you might put it there, and then just like all these other items, you can edit it, its properties. For example, the line style, you might change, for example, the size of the arrow. So you can maybe increase this one depending on the your requirements. Yeah, so you can always play around with this. So there's the north, and then so to indicate it north, you just add a label here and then place it there somewhere nicely. Then you're not there. Then you might come, you change to 28, for example. Yeah, there you are. Then one good thing is you can always set the where you want the text to appear. So for example, in this box, you might put maybe to center, that to center, which is me. So there you are. So it actually appears in a nice way. Then the other maps that maybe someone might want to add an image, maybe besides the maps that are shown, and then maybe you might also want to add maybe other features, for example, attributables and all those. If it's maybe the issue of, for example, them showing that this is a subset of this, so you can always use these arrows. So for example, if it's this corner here, you might show that it's this corner. And then this other one, so you make sure that this part is this. Yeah, that's it. So it's very simple actually, and very flexible, depending on the type of layout that you want for your maps. And then this map, you can always that maybe export it to in different formats that you want, and you share them with someone, or maybe with some, maybe it's your office. You can always share. This one, the way it is now, you can just import export in different formats, and these formats are just here, or maybe they can be found under here. So you can import export maybe as a as an image, for example. So maybe I go to lightweight, then maybe desktop, I go to tutorials, then maybe map. So I save that. So depending on the printing capabilities, you always know about the 300 DPI for maybe when you require to the resolution that you need when maybe you require to print. So you just save with the defaults. Then when I come now to the tutorial part here, and then click on this, manage there, very nice and good looking. Oh, this one has a displacement, I don't know why, but yeah. So you can export to PDF, for example. You can maybe save to the same folder. So this so map PDF. And it will be saved as PDF. And then when you come here, it's here. So these are some of the elements that at least you can use Map Composer, sorry, for, and do very nice looking maps for your project, map for maybe anything that you're doing with your QGIS project. And at the end of the day, you'll be having a very good stuff, like something you can even show that this was the project you're conducting. So that's it. You can explore more. You can actually, there are the symbols here. There are some other tools that you can still use. You can generate, maybe try to generate atlases from your maps here, and maybe form a very good output. You can always print directly the map that you've made, and at least you have a copy of the map. So that's it. So that was easy, and actually you've seen it, it's a very good way of doing maps. So thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe so that at least you get more of these videos and learn more and more in GIS. So thank you.